record. I never thought I'd be the one that you would break. But I will fight until the day the world stops turning. And it will fall to ashes, I will just keep burning. But tonight... Hi there, this is George from Spotlight Report. I'm here with Tonight Alive at the Sony Music Headquarters. How are you guys so far?
Amazing, we are really good.
So,
just gonna put it out there.
Of course. Okay, let's go to business. You guys have been smashing hits with the Edge. Hey. Like YouTube broke down when you released the single, and it keeps playing in radio. It's true. I saw that. What can you tell us about working on that song?
It was awesome. It was so fun to write because we had a storyline in mind. It wasn't coming from a personal experience. So, from a songwriting perspective, it was really refreshing for us to write that song. We wrote it acoustically. We were on tour when we got asked to write the song. And the outline for it was we want a dark, driving rock song with female vocals. And that's basically, I like to think that's like the description for our sound. So, I think it was just kind of a perfect opportunity for us. And I love how the song turned out. Yeah.
Also, this song was part of the Spider-Man 2 soundtrack, yes. which was like huge, and it kind of reminds us when Evanescence released Bring Me to Life for Daredevil. That was like a big kickstart on the career. So you feel this is your big chance to open new markets?
I guess it's just a different way of getting out to people that probably wouldn't have heard of us before. But yeah, I mean, we're just really privileged to be a part of such a great enterprise. I guess we've been fans of Spider-Man for
when we were growing up too.
Forever,
so
yeah.
This is like
Marvel.
The next generation of superhero kind of movies.
I love Daredevil. Oh, that Evanescence song is so good.
Amazing. Another sort of link, like you said, Evanescence, Killing Heidi, and another Australian band on the original Spider-Man movie did a song for the soundtrack called I Am. I'm pretty sure that's what it's called. Anyway, amazing song, and it's sorry, Killing Heidi, but I'm pretty sure that's what the song's called, and it's an amazing rock tune, and it's so cool that in the next sort of generation of Spider-Man that another Australian female fronted band got to be a part of the soundtrack. I just love that. Mm-hmm. I'm really excited about that.
Looking a bit back, how life-changing was to work with producer Mark Trombino?
Wow, that was a long time ago, but it really, you're right, it was sort of a point in our history. It was like a really challenging time. It was the first time we'd maybe been pushed that way.
Yeah, it was the first time we've ever been overseas out of our comfort zone. He had been used to working with a lot of bigger bands than us. We were very fresh. It was our first album, and I guess we had a lot to learn. And I think it was both a learning curve for us and him as well. But I think we got out of it so much more than just the album. I guess that was the first time we realized that what we wanted to do and the message that we wanted to send. And I'm really happy that we did that. I mean, at the time, it was really, really difficult, but it was definitely worth it.
It was. It was pretty eye-opening. It was the first time I'd been in front of a mic and heard my voice and not liked it. It was nothing to do with Mark. It was just that, I guess, since doing the first two EPs, my voice had changed and we were growing and changing. And I guess it was really confronting to hear my voice and be like, I'm not sure how to use it anymore, because I wasn't... I was still a little girl, but I guess, as I said, my voice was changing.
Not yet a woman.
So anyway, it was a growing point for the band, absolutely.
And following up on that, you pretty much answered part of this question, but mm-hmm. How do you feel the band has evolved from the first EP until now with The Edge?
I think we figured out what we want and who we are and what we're trying to do, and I think our sound is the closest to what we've ever wanted it to be. From the beginning, we always liked... From our first EP, Wasting Away, from our second EP, Revenge and Its Steals, from the first record, Listening, Breaking and Entering, What Are You So Scared Of? And then I guess those are, what they have in common is that they're all in minor keys and they're all dark, driving rock songs.
What's a key?
Beg your pardon?
Minor. What's a key?
Minor key, not a major key, yeah, right? Yeah. Don't test my musical inclination. Anyway, I as I said, I think we've figured out who we are and what we want. And the other side is an album that we're really proud of. And The Edge is kind of like the next step forward again.
And you guys have been part of one of the biggest tours
worldwide, like the band's rap. And also recently, if I'm not mistaken, you went to UK with All Time Low,
right,
and the States with The Used.
Yes.
So what can you tell us about those tours?
I mean, that's another thing we're super privileged about, especially The Used and Take It Back Sunday. Obviously, they're bands that we've looked up to for forever, and bands that made it the reason why we want to be a band. So being a part of that is just, I guess, really a dream come true for us. And it's very eye-opening to see how they interact with each other after so long, and how their live show is, and
also with their success, how they treat other people.
Yeah.
Which, of course, we wouldn't be speaking about this if it was in a negative way. They're all bands that really looked after us as their support band and were friendly, and it was just obvious that they all love what they do. They're still excited, and they still get nervous before they play. To me, that shows that they really give a shit, and they're still really passionate about music.
Especially All Time Low, they were. I've never seen a band be a band, I guess, of their size, to be excited before a show, you know, and it not just be another show to them.
Yeah.
And they treated us better than we've ever been treated, which was amazing. So we're very, very privileged to be on those two tours.
Those are also two of the biggest tours we've ever been a part of. Those were sold-out rooms from 2,000 to 5,000 capacity. So it's just like getting in front of a lot of people. And I guess, again, that's kind of another turning point for our band. So, yeah, 2014's been a really good year so far.
Mm-hmm. On last time we spoke to you guys, you were about to play the rap here in Sydney. And it was Offspring headline, and you were very excited about Offspring. So I wonder, do you guys get to hang out and meet them?
Didn't meet the Offspring.
The Warped Tour was weird. I guess they run it like Soundwave as well, where because you play at a certain time, you have to leave at a certain time to get to the next venue.
Mm-hmm.
So we never really. The only time was in Sydney when we had a day off the next day in Sydney, so we got to actually watch them. But we only got to watch the Offspring and the bands that played later once, which was a shame. But it was still, we were very happy to be a part of the Warped Tour coming to Australia, because we feel like we're representing Australia, I guess, every time we go overseas, and we're very proud to be Australian. So it was great for us to be a part of Warped Tour for the first time in 11 years, I guess, when it came back.
Something that was so cool about it was that The Used, Simple Plan, Newfound Glory were all on the main stage, and they're all bands that we listened to in high school, and we've had the chance to now tour with all of them. It's just kind of freaky, but they're all bands that we love and put on an amazing show. And as Whakaio said, like, Warped Tour is something we always wanted to do, and as Australians it never came here, only once in 2001 or something.
I think it came a couple of times.
I guess we were too young to have known or gone to it. So anyway, it was a big privilege for us to be part of it.
Now guys, after the releasing The Edge, I imagine there's a new album coming up.
Well, actually, yes. In a couple of days, we're actually going away on a writing trip. We've been writing since The Other Side for a year and a half, so we've got a lot of material, but it's time to tie up all the loose ends and develop the ideas into completed songs. So we're hoping to have half a record by June and go and record it in December. So very excited.
Fingers crossed.
It's all coming together.
Fantastic. Can't wait to hear
it.
Thank you. Last time also we were talking about how many people was comparing you guys with Paramore, but suddenly after you launched the latest album, The Other Side,
yes,
and you play Around the World, those comments were like disappearing a bit.
It's very rare that we hear it anymore.
Yeah.
It's really nice.
Yeah. So why do you think was the main reason for that?
I mean, we always knew that was going to happen, I guess, or always wanted that to happen. I mean, obviously, it's so easy to just compare something, a lazy comparison, really, but we felt like we were always going to carve our own way and do our own thing, and we just kept at it and kept on writing the songs that we want to write and being the people that we are.
Mm.
And we just kept on that line and kept going, and now it's like, whatever. But Paramore's a different thing now. They're not...
They're growing and
they're
evolving
too. They're not a pop rock band, or they're not a pop punk band anymore, and I guess, yeah, they've developed into something
else. And our sound
is
changing too. It's really nice. It seems like we're going on our own paths. And I think it does sound, what we've sort of responded to that sounds a little negative, but I think it's so natural for someone to hear something and say, oh, it reminds me of this. And that's kind of like, really, that's okay. I mean, I think it just takes time to differentiate and appreciate the ways that it's different, and I think that we've finally solidified our sound and our live show and our message, and it's kind of obvious that we really aren't anything alike, so it's all good.
You mentioned that you will be changing your sound a bit, so which kind of new territories you will be exploring on the new record?
I think we're just not going to be close-minded about what we want to be, and we're just going to let it happen. We're not going to make a conscious decision to change anything or change our sound, but we definitely want to be more open to different styles, and we just want to write what we want to write, really, and hopefully it's good.
I can say that we really appreciate 90s pop and 90s rock, so I think that has been influencing the sound a little bit, which is exciting for me as a female singer to sort of hopefully be following the footsteps of these great songs that were by Bachelor Girl and Michelle Branch and Alanis Morissette, and even songs from Hole. I just am really excited to give our listeners kind of like a different side of us. But again, I really don't think it's too far from what we've done in the past. It's just...
in a better way.
Yeah, I think so.
And just to start wrapping up, classic question we always ask to our guests.
Sure.
So the first one is, is any band you would like to go on tour that you haven't been before? And which one and why?
I guess we've been really lucky. We've toured with so many bands that we've grown up listening to.
But?
But actually, we're playing Reading and Leeds, and on the same day that Blink-182 were playing. So
that's bizarre.
I guess that's super bizarre, but definitely, I guess, at the top of our dream list. So that, that's going to be great, I think.
An unrealistic one for me, but... still an honest answer is Rage Against the Machine. They're like my favourite band. I really, really admire the musicianship, but also the lyrics and the aggression and the power and the flow. I don't know, I'm a big fan of Rage, and I know it's probably never going to happen, but even if we're on a festival lineup together in the future, if they reform or make another album, that would be a dream come true for me.
And can you share with us any funny fan requests you ever have while on tour, or any fan story while on the road?
No.
I'll just start, because I can't think of anything, I'll just start by saying we have some really cool fans. I think the fans of Tonight Alive's music are always real people. I think they just appreciate the band for all the right reasons, and they're just honest, chill people. I really respect them.
I appreciate our fans in the way that they'll come to a show and doesn't matter who's playing, they'll give them a chance. And our fans aren't the cool people that stand up the back of the room with their arms crossed. Like, our fans are the ones that are on the barriers and really willing to check out anyone. And I think that's what music's really all about, and finding that something, because you never know, you might love that band, that might be your next favourite band, and they're always so open-minded, so...
I also think that Tonight Alive is not really a trendy band. I think we just write music that we want to write, and we don't necessarily dress fashionably or promote ourselves in like a niche. So I think that's good for us, because we've attracted the same type of people, and we kind of just get along. So sorry there wasn't a funny story, but
no.
I think I like the turnaround.
That takes me to the last part of this interview. I would like you guys to take the microphone and send a message to your Australian fans.
Absolutely.
And international fans as well, of course.
Okay.
All yours.
Thank you. Well, we'll start with the Aussie fans. We miss you guys every time we're away, and we will never forget that the reason that we were even able to go overseas in the first place was because of you guys giving us a chance here. And it is a really hard market in Australia, especially for anyone really, but for our genre, I don't really feel that... the scene, it's making a comeback, and we're working on it. So anyway, thanks for keeping the faith. I'm going to hand over to you for the internationals.
No, you do it. You're just going to say better than me.
I mean, what can I say? This is something that we've dreamed about since we were young, and especially for an Australian band, the rest of the world is so far away, and you really have to get a break to be able to do what we're doing. And we've been really lucky. We've supported a lot of our favourite bands, and we've played venues that we've supported in, and now we get to headline in. So I guess we can't thank you enough for making our dreams come true. It's cheesy, but it's true. So
awesome.
There it is.
Thank you.
Okay, guys. Well, thank you so much for
thank
your
you.
Time.
It's
been a pleasure talking to you again.
Thank you.
Take care and all the best, and looking forward for the new album.
Thank you very much.
Bye.